Welcome to a new programming video tutorial. My purpose here is to show you how SwiftUI makes it really easy to apply a mask on any view simply by using a view modifier and providing a shape. As you can see, it literally takes a single line of code. But on top of that, I will also present a technique on how to change the mask shape on the fly, and finally, how to use a custom shape besides the built-in ones. First things first, so let's get started by demonstrating the simplest and most common use case. What you see here is a simple view that contains an image view along with a few modifiers. Following the order they are called, these modifiers make the image resizable, apply the scale to fit aspect ratio, and dictate a specific size for the image view. If I run the app at this point, what we'll get is what we expect to see, an image with specified dimensions. The view modifier we need to use here is called clipShape. We must fit it with an argument, and that argument has to be an instance of a type conforming to shape protocol. In this particular example here, I'm going to add the clipShape modifier right before the frame modifier. Note that the order of view modifiers in SwiftUI matters. If I would have added it last, then the final result would look cropped. As argument, I will pass a circle shape like so. Let's run again now to see the results. Say that a circular mask has been applied to the image view. With just this one view modifier, we achieved that effect with no effort at all. There are various built-in shapes that we could use in place of circle. For example, the clip shape modifier can be supplied with a rounded rectangle along with a radius value, an ellipse, capsule, and of course the rectangle shape. Most of the times, doing something as shown here will be sufficient. You apply the clip shape modifier, you provide a desired shape object, and that's it. Without a move, you have a masked view. However, what if you wanted to change the applied mask on the fly? I will show you a simple technique here that will let you change the clipShape argument value easily. Let's get started with an enum containing all shapes we'd like to make available. For the sake of the demonstration, I will set string as the raw value type for the enum cases, and I will also adopt the case iterable protocol. Doing so will let me iterate through all cases easily next. Now, this is really important. I will add one more conformance, and that will be to the shape protocol. If you remember, I mentioned earlier that the arguments provided to clipShape modifier should be objects of types adopting shape. Adopting the latter introduces a requirement to this new type, which we'll focus on in a moment. Right now, let's add the various cases of the enum, where each one will represent a built-in shape. The shape protocol requires for many type adopting it to implement a particular method. A method that returns the path of the shape as a path object, named path in. The rect parameter value represents the bounding frame of the shape as a cdirect value. What I'll do here is to return the path of each built-in shape matching to each single case. And for that, I will use a switch statement. See that for each case, I'm creating the respective shape instance and returning its path by accessing the path in method of each one, supplying it at the same time with the rect parameter value. With that new enum in place, let's declare the following state property in our view now. Instead of a particular shape, we'll pass the shape property as argument to the clipShape modifier. To demonstrate changing on the fly, we'll add a picker view right after the image view. I won't stick to the picker details right now, but it would be interesting to look at how we iterate through all available shape cases in a for each container. Something that becomes feasible thanks to the conformance to case iterable protocol. In the for each body, there is a button that displays the raw value of each shape case as labeled. When clicked, it updates the value of the shape property with the selected one, which changes the applied mask eventually in turn. Let's see all the above running. See that every time I choose a shape, the applied clip shape on the image view gets updated accordingly. So far, we met only system-provided shapes, but the clipShape modifier can also accept custom shapes as well. To see that, let's define a new type that conforms to the shape protocol. instances of this type will create a pentagon shape. As we have already seen, it's mandatory to define the pathIn method in every type that adopts the shape protocol, and this is no exception. When it's padded, we actually draw the shape as we want it to be. Getting into details about how to do that is out of scope here. So, here is the implementation we need at once. These lines of code define the path of pentagon in any given frame. Back to the SwiftUI view, we can either pass a pentagon instance as argument to clipShape modifier, or add it as an additional case to the available shapes in enum. Let's go for the latter, and let's make the necessary modifications to the enum. The custom shape is used just like the built-in ones. When I run the app, that new shape is there among the rest, and I can choose it so I change the clip shape on the fly. So that's all about the clipShape view modifier in SwiftUI. It's really easy to use it, and besides the basics, you now also know how to switch among multiple shapes easily. I hope you found this video useful. You will find a link to a text tutorial right on the same topic in the description, as well as a link to my website where you can find additional programming content to read. Please subscribe to my channel if you like this video, and don't forget to use the thumb up button to also show me that. Take care, and thanks for watching.